how is a nutrition assessment relevant in the field of respiratory care? That's probably what you're thinking, right? I want to be a respiratory therapist, so why do I need to know about a patient's nutritional status? And that is a valid question. But consider this. Nutrition is vital to life, just like oxygen. You can only go so long without oxygen, and you can only go so long without proper food and nutrients as well. And that is the topic of this video. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. So, what is a nutrition assessment? A nutrition assessment is a process of analyzing and evaluating the overall nutritional status of a patient. A registered dietitian is typically the medical professional who is most involved in this process. However, it is important for respiratory therapists to develop an understanding as well. That is because certain cardiopulmonary conditions may have increased energy requirements. This means that without the essential nutrients, you may not be able to provide a patient with other important therapeutic modalities. Nutrition is important in respiratory care because oxygen is required for the cellular metabolism of carbohydrates, lipids, and protein. These nutrients are converted into energy that the body needs in order to function properly. This includes all of the major organs and systems of the body. Also, you may be wondering, what is the best diet for patients with a respiratory condition? Unfortunately, it's impossible to provide a definitive answer to this question, because each patient is different. Some patients may benefit from one diet where it could do more harm than good to others. With that said, as a respiratory therapist, there are a few generalizations that can be made. For example, a patient who is critically ill with a severe infection may require more protein intake than normal. A patient with COPD may benefit from eating frequent smaller meals that are high in fat and low in carbohydrates. A patient with asthma may benefit from smaller meals that are high in protein. Also, asthmatic patients should avoid foods known to have allergens, as they may increase the likelihood of an acute attack. And patients with cystic fibrosis are often malnourished. Therefore, in general, they typically benefit from a diet that is high in fat and sodium. But again, these are just a few generalized examples. Keep in mind that each and every patient is different, which means that a proper nutritional regimen should be implemented with the help of a qualified dietitian and physician. But real quick, if you don't mind, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And you might as well go ahead and subscribe for more videos like this. Hopefully what you learned in this video was useful and can help you develop a better understanding of this topic. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to dive even deeper, we do have a full guide on our website. I will drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friends.